ancient town of Lunawada stands the palace of King Colonel Maharaja Vir Bhadra Singhhji, which was built in the 18th century. This palace was built in a valley formed by surrounding hills so that the hills act as natural fortified wall for safety. This arrangement of palace is known as Parikha. Entering the palace complex through the tower gate, the tower earlier used to be the highest building in the town, with four stories and individual balconies at each floor. It was erected for guarding the palace premises and for seeing the time. The red arrow shows the king's direct entry into the palace, while the green for the commoners. On the right side is the stable, where the horses were kept at the lower level and the horse riders stayed at the upper level. The front building was constructed into two halves. The right side part was built later. The front facade had beautifully decorated balcony with embossment, which shows the king's love for art and culture. The main entrance doors have spikes projecting out so as to make it more difficult for the enemies to break the doors. For breaking the doors, elephants ran and pushed the doors to open it, but the main gate has an indirect entry which does not allow the sufficient runway path for the elephant to break the door. The fortified walls were made up of combination of rubble and brick masonry. Now, coming into the palace premises. Entering into the oldest interior part of the palace, we come to the Moti Mahal. It was the residence of king and his guest. The mahal has large windows and doors and beautifully embossed projecting balcony or jarukhas. This resembled to the old pole house windows and balconies, which open up into the courtyard for proper ventilation and light. The courtyard of the palace were utilized for a list of activities from royal audiences to religious festivals, while the rooftop and the highest courtyards were used as outdoor bedchambers in the hot weather conditions. This interplay of indoor and outdoor space was one of the hallmarks of the Indian palace architecture, where much more importance was given to the flow of cool air. This mahal premises has the town's oldest temple, from where the whole journey of establishment of Lunawada began. Next to the king's palace is the Nazarbagh palace or the queen's residence. Here we can see the experimentation of permutation and combination of elliptical and circular arches with beautiful color glass decoration, which added more drama to the queen's life. This is the king's direct entrance, from where the king could enter any part of the palace in lesser time. This staircase is made so narrow that when attacked by enemies, only one soldier could block this direct entry. The risers are very high with narrow treaders, which add to the more difficulty for two people to climb at the same time. The enemies first attack the Rajput quarters to ensure none of the royal blood remains alive to succeed the throne when the kingdom is annexed. Meanwhile, when the enemies attack the orange area, the queen would escape by the path shown by the red arrow and the king by the blue arrow, which had a hidden exit at the hill from the circular chowki at the entrance. When anyone came to meet the king or for hearing in the Diwan-e-Aam, he had to pass through 9 security checkposts with semicircular archway and height less than 3 meters. The courtyard of the palace are symmetrically planned, which has 3 arches on each face of the square. This abides by the diagram of Vastu Purusha Mandal. Climbing up to the Sachivalay or the Diwan-e-Aam, where the High Court hearing was done, now the room is used by the royal family to preserve the king's belongings. The room has windows which are window cum door, which is used to bring light to the Diwan-e-Aam and also act as raised doorway to move to the facade balcony. The balcony is made up of mixture of cement and lime with proper reinforcement called sago. The ornamental balcony is narrow and it allows only one person to pass at a time, while the floor is made up of kota stone supported by the wooden structural member. From this balcony, the king used to have an overall glance of the town. Climbing up from the garden, we reach the Diwan-e-Khas or the Darbar Hall. The hall has two stories, lower of 3.5 meter and upper of 2 meters height. The hall has wedge-shaped doorways to concentrate more light and air circulation. Mirrors were placed in the gap between the doors so as to keep an eye on every movement in the hall. This use of mirror facing each other added more volume to the lower level and gave the feeling of illumination of wall. The hall has wooden columns and girders and carved brackets. A separate entry was made for the king. In the lower part of the session, hearing was done and the woman and the queen used to see through the curtains from the above balcony. Sheesh Mahal or the ceremonial hall of the royal family, or hall where the king used to see the dancing and the art of his subjects. The roof is made up of wooden vault in the center and mirror on its adjacent sides, which gave an illusion of walking through the vault when its reflection is casted on the floor, as the floor was also made up of mirror. The wall was made dramatical by making it with decorated glass color painting of different animals, birds and reptiles with natural colors, which made the sheesh mail seem light and bring in a good light which gets reflected and would lit up the hall with color light. It has wooden frame supporting the glass and iron brackets which strengthen it more, with a sloping roof above, adding to its beauty. The red arrow shows the normal door, while the orange shows the slider door, which were made to save the time. In general palace architecture, there is Queen's Palace, King's Palace, Diwan-e-Am, Diwan-e-Khas and Sheesh Mahal. All this was to be arranged in a cluster and separated with a distance gap. But in Lunawada Palace, space is divided by making a maze of courtyards which are placed in a line, making it more experiential when visited from inside. The palace was built in both colonial and Rajputana style of palace architecture. The circular windows, jacquard flooring, colonial painting, elliptical arch, the wooden vault, sloping roof show the colonial part of it, while the huge windows, projecting balcony and the front facade decoration show the Rajputana style of architecture.